Hello and welcome to Patient Power. I'm Andrew Shore. Today, what is an e-patient? I like to call them powerful patients. What is that today? Well, really, no one knows better than someone known as ePatient Dave. That's Dave DeBronckhart from Nashua, New Hampshire. We caught up with him at the European Society of Medical Oncology ESMO meeting in Madrid.
E-patient, first of all, the word, there was a doctor named Tom Ferguson who came up with that word in the 1990s. When he was a visionary, because back in the 80s, he was the medical editor of the Whole Earth Catalog, which is sort of a post-Woodstock hippie journal on how to build your own house, grow your own food, and be responsible for yourself medically. You know, most of what we do is take care of ourselves and our families at home, but when trouble hits, he knew that a big factor that limited our ability to contribute value was access to information. And that's why the internet was so transformational. And he predicted some things that would start happening, and then he spotted people who were doing it. And then he coined this term e-patient. Originally it meant electronic, like online patients, but then it came to mean educated, engaged, empowered, equipped, enabled, all kinds of E words. The way that I distinguish an e-patient from one who's not is a disempowered, disengaged patient treats medicine as if they were a car in a car wash. They roll up the windows and they just get things done to them as they go through the process. Where an engaged patient says, let me understand, I have some questions, and they go do what they can to help. Now, what we're talking about here is a shift in the relationship between the patient and the professional, all right? And that's a culture change. It's exactly the same as women's rights, civil rights, gay rights. The most activated version that I know of in recent history is the HIV/AIDS movement, where the patient spoke up and said to the FDA, most notably, we're dying here, change your process. You know, give us a cure. And I heard a speaker the other night at a reception say that he was involved in that on the government side at the time, and he believes that the activated patients there accelerated the delivery of a cure by 10 years. 10 years. So, but in order for a rebalanced relationship to work, you need the previously suppressed party to step up, and you need the other party to welcome it and not smack it down. So that's the accepting, rebalancing relationship.
What are the challenges faced by today's e-patients? We'll find out some interesting perspectives from e-patient Dave DeBronckhart coming up in our next segment from our interview with him in Madrid. Be sure to be signed up for alerts on our website so you'll know whenever we post something new. I'm Andrew Shore. Remember, knowledge can be the best medicine of all.